want it like me, cause I need to break. She can count up. She try to be nosy and hit her back. She like, girl, you can count. We need more, tell them we need more. Put numbers.
Power up and level up at any moment. Spitting like a semi, only give me semicolon. Couple zeros like I'm sending yell nets. Every flow is unmatched and I better get set in. Finish them,
finish them.
Mess around with me and I diminish them all. Even if I ever did the minimum all.
In the end result, I better kill them all. Rogue one, but I got a team with me. Batman when I got a thing with me. I get mean, I get green. Show the whole game what's never been seen. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Shawshank, cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
Designer sneakers hurt my feet now. Every beat is getting beat down. Couldn't eat, well, watch I eat now.
Hello, everybody. It's the Coach.
Well, it was a common sight in the 80s and 90s, not quite as frequent since, but it's back. Playoff football in the Bay Area here at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl, and we've got a classic in store between the Green Bay Packers and the San Francisco 49ers.
That's it, baby. We got work. 56,
from the 34 now, here's first and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. It's complete to Williams. Good work after the catch. Gonna net him 23 and a first.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker, maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Watch the run, watch the run.
There goes a deep ball, end zone, and that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. And Adams has it, complete. Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams. 34 yards as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator? Remember what he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers.
Here we go.
Led out by a guy who learned from one of the great ones in his first few years in Tom Brady. This is Jimmy Garoppolo.
When you're back up to one of the all-time great players, if you don't spend time picking that guy's brain or just watching and observing how he does things to increase your game, then you've wasted that time. I don't think Jimmy Garoppolo is that type of a player. I think those lessons learned have a chance to transmit themselves very well.
Give him 2 yards that time, and it's going to leave him with a third and 11 situation.
Here we go.
The Packers bringing in an extra member of the secondary here to try for the third down stop. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. Open man is Pettis. It's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 21 yards there on third down.
Here we go.
What do you need?
Check, Mike 42.
First down. They'll run with Coleman on first down. Now a loose football. Coleman lost it, and the Packers pick it up. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
Face mask. Defense.
So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. Throwing now is Rodgers. He's got the hook up to Lazard. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. A 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. They've got to be thrilled on the road right now. Touchdown, turnover, touchdown, and quickly trying to make it 14 to nothing.
Yeah, I mentioned it already. On the road, to be able to go into someone else's house and establish a start like that, obviously your confidence rises in a big way, and you're putting some doubt in their minds.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Should have been picked. Probably doesn't matter on a two-point conversion, but still, as a former DB, you want to grab that ball when you can, don't you?
You certainly do, and don't say it, because I know you're thinking it. Don't say it.
What am I thinking?
You know what I know what you're thinking. Well, if he'd had hands, he'd be playing on offense, right?
That's true. You've said that before. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20.
Let go!
Here we go. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. They'll need to come from behind if they want to play in 2 weeks as they trail early in this NFC Championship game. Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Play fake there to Coleman. Now Garoppolo. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 40, and his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. So after the INT, it's Rodgers. And that's complete to Adams. That goes for a gain of 31. How about this first quarter for them throwing the football?
This defense has zero answers for what they've seen so far with the ball in the air. I'm not sure how they're...
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers.
Touchdown.
A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further.
Well, Brandon, if we go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator, he showed us his script. Didn't show us everything now. He said, here's the script for the game. I think everything's going according to plan in a big way. 3 drives, 3 touchdowns.
Yeah, that's about as good as, that is as good as you can do, I guess. So, well done.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, well done indeed. Tremendous execution.
And the formula there on the 2-point try, they go 5 wide. Not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
Here comes Jimmy Garoppolo now to lead his offense back out there. And he'll look to rebound from the early interception that led to 6 points the other way.
And when he threw the interception and he had to come to the sideline, I guarantee his first thought wasn't about the interception itself, but what could result. And I know he was thinking to himself, come on, defense.
He's got a man complete. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
That's a great job of working the sideline right there. I love how he tracked the football the whole way. Just reached up and pulled it in. Had excellent field presence to understand where he was in order to make that play happen.
And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. Garoppolo on the draw to Coleman. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Garoppolo now able to haul it in as Kittle. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 24-yard line.
Here we go. Like 20!
21-0, our score after one. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Garoppolo finding his tight end Kittle. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And the Packers pick it up. Uses the stiff arm. And a great return as he takes us up just shy of the 45.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense.
15-18! 54, Mike. You got 15.
Rodgers now on first down. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right of the yard.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it. Sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
And it is 58!
56. Check 56.
Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And some room to roam now. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Jamal Williams with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting field position for the 49ers as they have it first and 10 at their own 43. Now a throw over the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. Nothing at all on that one. It'll be second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He can make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. On second down, it's Coleman. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a third and 11 situation. Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they will score. It's a Packer touchdown. That pick six extending this lead even further. And boy, it's been a while since I've seen a team struggle this badly in the first half.
I think all they want to do is get to the locker room, try and regroup, and come out to start the third quarter. But if things don't improve fast then, I think the backups get a lot of play in the second half.
Here's Rodgers. And he's got it. They add on more. A little salt in the wound. Two-point conversion makes this lead even bigger. And they turn the pick six into a pick eight with that two-point conversion.
I love how you upset. That is outstanding right there. What a big-time play. Big switch in how this game was going. And then they capitalize a little bit on top.
Let's go!
San Francisco coming back out here on offense. You see, this is a team that as in the midst of their first playoff appearance since 2013. Biggest jump of any squad, because just 4 wins last year, 13 this year, and that win in Seattle, week 17, so huge. A tackle by Dre Greenlaw and Jacob Hollister on the half-yard line to preserve the victory. You think about the magnitude of that play. What a difference it would be between 3 road games if they would have been the number 5 seed versus 2 potential home games as the number 1 seed.
If they find a way to win the Super Bowl, that tackle will be remembered. It's already there with Dan Bunce's hit in the Super Bowl against Pete Johnson, the Cincinnati Bengals.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Kevin King with a pick. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. So second down and 10 once again. He'll get this off to Jamal Williams. Bounds. Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. He's got Adams on the hookup. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Rodgers finding Adams for a Packer first. 2 minutes remain in the first half of this NFC Championship. And a reminder, folks, as we've done all year, we'll send you to Orlando for our EA Sports Halftime Report coming up shortly. The coach with us, as always, as he will start to look ahead to Super Bowl 53. And now running right through him. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
Let's go, boys. Let's go. Let's go.
A good-looking drive for the Packers so far. It's a first down. A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. Touchdown, Packers! Aaron Rodgers, 3 first-half touchdown passes as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. They went empty backfield, all their weapons out wide, so there really was no secret here to what they were going to do.
No secret, but they still had to execute it, and they still had to protect the guy throwing the ball, because oftentimes when you empty the backfield, people bring pressure at you. They managed to hold in there and successfully complete the touchdown pass.
Now Rodgers, and this is going to be caught. Well, not sure about the need to go for 2, but they get it and extend this lead out even further. So they go with a pass, and it works there on the 2-point try. Charles, just in general, what are your thoughts passing versus running on 2-point conversion? Situational?
It is situational, and you have to know your team. What is your strength? Because so many people think you have to throw the ball on a 2-point conversion, but the stats will tell you that running it is about as proficient. So know your team and go to your strength.
Here we go.
Tight right.
We got 3 down.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Blake Martinez, the linebacker, was there in coverage to disrupt. Well, CD, with the end of the season comes the announcement of the All-Pro team, and everybody was like, wait a second, Christian McCaffrey's listed twice. Is that a mistake? No, he got it both at running back and flex. Pretty impressive.
Very impressive, because I think a lot of people thought that if you have a running back and a flex position, that maybe Christian McCaffrey would go into the flex because he catches the ball so well. And he would go ahead and elevate the big guy out of Tennessee, Derrick Henry, to the All-Pro running back. Henry ends up being a second-team guy. But McCaffrey deserves being first-team running back as well as first-team flex. He had a tremendous, spectacular year.
And as you might imagine, Baltimore leads the way. 5 players named to the All-Pro selection. Of course, leading the way for them, the quarterback Lamar Jackson.
Yes, and rightly so. And I fully expect him to be named the MVP when we get to NFL honors right before the Super Bowl. He's going to sweep all of those, and he deserves it. Carried that team throughout the season and got better in their bigger games.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Debo Samuel was the intended receiver, but it'll be second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now Garoppolo, and his throw here is incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver. But now it's third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions. Have a look at it. Third and 10. Garoppolo. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Adrian Amos with a pick. We haven't even escaped the first half, and he's already thrown four picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw four.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And shedding him off. Now open field. And he makes it all the way down to the 31.
Let's go.
A big play there just before halftime. 66 yards. So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. Still on his feet. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. This clearly the final play of the half, but no field goal attempt. They're going for it with 3 seconds remaining. Got a man open. It's Adams. Touchdown, Green Bay. Four touchdown passes now for Aaron Rodgers as his guys continue to pour it on. Rodgers now to throw. And it's going to be caught. Not sure why they went for two, but they do get it. So we've reached halftime here in the NFC Championship as we send you cross-country to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks. As always, one half remains in the battle to see who will take home that George Halas Trophy and represent the NFC in the Super Bowl. We'll get back to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's look back to the AFC Championship game held earlier today. And it's the Kansas City Chiefs who are heading to the Super Bowl as they await the winner of this NFC Championship game. So with that, let's get you right back out for the second half as one of these teams will represent the NFC in the Super Bowl. To find out who, let's turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
The Halas Trophy still hangs in the balance as the second half now underway in the NFC Championship game. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it?
Let's go, baby.
They say
let's
just
go.
Outside the The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They'll try and get the running game going with Jones. And he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. To throw is Rodgers. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down, but a nice little game. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less as they come up on second and inches. Jones. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Taking it in from 14 yards out as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. Well, Charles, fans around here, they were already talking Super Bowl. They've made plans. You just can't look past anybody in this league, especially this deep into the playoffs.
You would think that every year that message would say.